Assalamu alaikum. My name is Dr. Muhammad Mustafa Shaheen. As we are talking about preventive dental materials, in last lecture we discussed about different types of preventive materials available in dentistry, toothbrushes and their types, dentifrices, their composition and types, dentifloss and its uses, interdental cleansing brushes and mouthwash, its composition, types and uses in dentistry. In today's lecture we will talk about fluorides and its different forms available in market and what we are using, which we are using in dentistry, modes of administration of fluoride supplements, indications for fluoride supplements, clinical procedures for fluoride application, mode of action of fluorides, recommended supplemental fluoride dose schedule, what are Pitts and Fisher sealants, indications for Pitts and Fisher sealants application, clinical technique or procedure of Pitts and Fisher sealants application, different materials used as Pitts and Fisher sealants. About toothbrushes, mouthwash, dentifloss, interdental toothbrushes, we have discussed these materials in our previous lecture. In today's lecture we will discuss about fluorides and dental official sealants. Fluorides are available in the form of gels, foam and varnish. Fluorides are used for remineralization of decalcified enamel and incipient caries, whereas Pitt and Fisher sealants are indicated for preventing arresting incipient lesions. Pitt and Fisher sealants are available as clear or white, filled or unfilled, containing fluoride or not. If we talk about fluorides, fluorides are available in the form of gels, foam, mouthwash and varnishes. Acidulated phosphate fluoride is available in the form of gel. Percent sodium fluoride is also available in the form of gel or varnish. 0.34% hydrofluoric acid or hydrogen fluoride is also available, and 0.98% phosphoric acid is also used. 4 minutes of application of fluorides is optimal. No eating or drinking for 1 hour post application is recommended. Applied the fluoride varnishes twice a year. In picture you can see mouthwash, fluoride gel, fluoride varnish. Fluoride is present in our diet and we are taking in the form of water supply or supplements. Water fluoridation was begun in 1945. Water fluoridation affects almost 50% of the population, and it can provide a 50% reduction in dental caries. Fluoride supplements. Prior to recommending supplementary fluoride, the fluoride content of the child's total water intake must be determined, because if we give fluoride in excess dose, it can cause fluoride toxicity, and it can also cause fluorosis in the teeth. Self-administered fluoride application, which is done by patient individually. Fluoride is present in our daily use toothpaste. 15-30% of caries reduction following the regular use of fluoride dentifrices is seen. The most common fluoride compound are sodium monofluorophosphate, stannous fluoride, and sodium fluoride. These fluoride compounds are present in our daily use toothpaste. Anti-calculus agents such as zinc compound or pyrophosphate can be used in combination with fluoride in toothpaste to reduce the deposition of calculus on the teeth surfaces. Fluoride can also be used in the form of mouthwash. Indication for fluoride mouthwash are patient with active caries, orthodontic patient, if any patient has braces, it is quite difficult for him to clean his teeth effectively. That's why fluoride mouthwash is recommended. Next indication for mouthwash use is patient with reduced salivary flow. If any patient has any certain disease in which salivary flow is reduced, and especially aged patient has low salivary flow, in those patient fluoride mouthwash is recommended. Next indication for the use of fluoride mouthwash is patient with removable appliances. Patient having removable dentures are more at the risk of caries. So in those patient, fluoride mouthwash is recommended. 0.05% neutral sodium fluoride, which contains almost 230 parts per million fluoride, is the benefit concentration. It means in our daily use mouthwash, the concentration of fluoride which is effective is 0.05%. 1-2 teaspoon, which is almost 5-10 ml of fluoride mouthwash, is recommended to use before going to bed once a day. Fluoride supplements are available in the form of topical fluoride or systemic fluorides. In picture you can see fluoride tablets which are given to the children above the age of 6 years. This is an example of systemic fluoride. In another picture you can see Colgate Durafet topical fluoride. It is loaded into the special tray and patient is advised to insert the tray into mouth for a recommended period of time. Topical fluoride can also be used at home, or can also be used at professional clinics. If we are recommended fluoride supplements in the form of systemic supplements, systemic supplements are available in the form of drops, chewable tablets, tablets in combination with vitamins. Doses for the systemic fluoride supplements are 0.25 milligram, 0.5 milligram, and 1 milligram. It depends upon the age of patient and concentration of fluoride in his body. That's why it is recommended that patient's serum fluoride level should be tested before prescribing him or her systemic fluoride supplements. Topical fluorides can reduce caries up to 20 to 40%. Topical fluorides can also be applied professionally in dental clinics. Or you can also use topical fluorides in the form of mouthwash, which is used over the period of time. You can also prescribe topical fluoride in the form of gels and dentifrices. Topical fluoride is also present in the form of fluoride varnish. 0.5% sodium fluoride is used as a fluoride varnish. Fluoride varnish has long history in Europe. It has excellent clinical effectiveness. Fluoride varnish has shown excellent clinical effectiveness. 0.1% difluorosilane is an example of fluoride varnish. Fluoride varnish is easy to use. Just paint a thin layer on the dry surface of teeth and avoid swallowing for next 24 hours. After applying the fluoride varnish, there is a yellowing of teeth for next 24 hours, a slight yellowing. No. What is the procedure of application of fluoride varnish? First of all, fluoride varnish is recommended as prophylaxis for dental caries. It means to prevent dental caries, it is recommended to have fluoride varnish. First of all, we will clean and polish the tooth surface on which we have to apply the varnish. Then isolate the teeth with the help of cotton gauze, cotton roll, rubber dam. Dry the teeth with the help of air syringe. After that, apply 2% sodium fluoride on each surface with the help of cotton applicator. Fluoride varnish should be applied on each surface, buccally, lingually, occlusally, proximal surfaces. The solution is allowed to dry on the teeth for 3 to 5 minutes. The same procedure is repeated every week until next 4 applications. Again, same procedure for fluoride application, cleansing and cleaning and polishing of the teeth, followed by drying and isolation of teeth with the help of cotton gauze, rubber dam or cotton roll. 2% sodium fluoride is then applied with cotton applicators and is permitted to dry on the teeth for about 4 minutes. Repeated for the remaining quadrants. Avoid eating, drinking for rinsing. Avoid eating, drinking or rinsing for 30 minutes after the application of the fluoride varnish. Second, third and fourth applications are given at weekly interval at 3, 7 and 11 and then 13 years. Stannous fluoride and acetylated phosphate fluoride are also used as fluoride varnish. Stannous fluoride is a single annual application of 8% stannous fluoride, which can reduce 65% caries incidence. Need to be prepared freshly for each application. 0.8 gram in 10 ml distilled water. In case of acetylated phosphate fluoride, combination of sodium fluoride with phosphoric acid is used. No need to be prepared every treatment. Now, what is the mode of action of fluoride? Ionic exchange. Hydroxyapatite crystals are changed to fluoroapatite crystals, which is less soluble in acids produced by bacteria. Enzymatic inhibition. Inhibit phosphatase and annulase enzymes. Fluoride also causes bacterial inhibition. Fluoride has the ability to precipitate calcium phosphate on the surface of enamel from saliva. Fluoride lowers free surface energy, which leads to reduced plaque accumulation in the treated enamel surface. Fluoride has action on tooth size and morphology. Shallow the fissures and lower cusp height and smaller size, which leads to decrease the caries incidence. Fluoride also inhibit glucosyl transferase enzyme. Streptococcus mutant bacteria use this glucosyl transferase enzyme to produce dextrin to attach to teeth. It means if we inhibit glucosyl transferase enzyme by applying fluoride varnish or by giving fluoride supplements to the patient, then there will be no substrate for bacteria, so it will not attach to teeth to cause caries. Fluoride also prevents smooth surface caries. Fluoride do not prevent caries on pit and fissure surfaces, which means sealants prevents pit and fissure caries. Toxic fluoride dose is fluoride dose is 5 mg/kg. Lethal dose is 20 mg/kg. Antidote for fluoride toxicity is milk and antacid containing calcium. This is the diagrammatic presentation of mode of action of fluoride. In demineralization, plaque acid enters enamel rods in the teeth and break down enamels, which leads towards the cavity formation. When we apply fluoride, it causes remineralization. In the remineralization, Fluoride enters into enamel rods in the tooth to treat enamel lesions. Enamel is remineralized after addition of fluoride. In picture you can see there is a layer of fluoride which prevents demineralization of enamel rods. This is a very important chart. American Dental Association recommended supplemental fluoride dose schedule. If a child on birth to up to 6 months has less than 0.3 parts per million water concentration, if a child from birth to 6 months has less than 0.3 parts per million water fluoridation concentration, then there will be no recommendation to use fluoride supplement. If the water fluoridation concentration is between 0.3 to 0.6 parts per million, there will be no recommendation for the use of fluoride supplement. And if child has greater than 0.6 parts per million water fluoridation concentration, then there will be no recommendation for fluoride supplement. Child whose age is 6 months to 3 years has less than 0.3 parts per million water fluoride concentration, in that case we will give 0.25 milligram fluoride liquid drops in the form of supplemental fluoride. And if that child has water fluoride concentration from 0.3 to 0.6 parts per million, then there will be no need for fluoride supplements. And if water fluoridation concentration is greater than 0.6 parts per million, then there will be no need for fluoride supplements. If a child of 3 to 6 years has less than 0.3 parts per million water fluoride concentration, we will give him 0.5 milligram drops or tablets in the form of fluoride supplement. And if he has water fluoride concentration between 0.3 to 0.6 parts per million, then we will give him or her 0.25 milligram fluoride supplement in the form of tablet or drops. And if water fluoride concentration is greater than 0.6 parts per million, then we will not recommend any fluoride supplement. If a child whose age is 6 to 16 years and has water fluoride concentration less than 0.3 parts per million, then we will prescribe him 1 milligram fluoride supplement. And if that child has water fluoride concentration between 0.3 to 0.6 parts per million, then we will prescribe him 0.5 milligram fluoride supplement. And if he has water fluoride concentration greater than 0.6 parts per million, then we will not prescribe any fluoride supplement. So this chart is very important. फॉर एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, फ्रॉम एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, दिस इज द क्लासिकल पिक्चर ऑफ फ्लोरोसिस. नो, वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट पीट एंड फिशर कैरिज एंड पीट एंड फिशर सीलेंट्स. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ग्राफ. इन दिस ग्राफ यू कैन सी they are 84% a closer caries and just 16% proximal caries. In USA, what is pits and fissure sealants? The term pit and fissure sealant is used to describe a material that is introduced into the occlusal pits and fissures of caries susceptible teeth, thus forming a micromechanically bonded protective layer, cutting excess of caries producing bacteria from their source of nutrients. Fissure sealant is a low viscosity material which is flow into the pre-treated pit or fissure on occlusal buccal palatal surfaces which fills the pits and fissures. This material polymerizes into a hard material. Pit and fissure sealant acts as a physical barrier between the sealed area of the tooth and the bacteria in the oral cavity. Sealants are used as preventive and therapeutic treatment. Pit and fissure sealants is usually a non-invasive procedure, but in some cases it could be invasive procedure, and obviously it's a preventive procedure. Sealants seal deep and narrow grooves. Dental sealants act as a barrier to prevent cavities. They are a tooth colored resin material applied to the chewing surface on the back teeth or posterior teeth. Sealants protect deep grooves in teeth by sealing out plaque and food. Usually, sealants are put on the permanent teeth which erupt during 6 years to 12 years of patient age, which are usually molars and premolars, in order to protect them from caries. Sealants hold up well under the force of normal chewing and may last several years before reapplication is necessary. To ensure the longevity of your child's sealants, we recommend minimizing chewing hard candies and ice. The American Dental Association recommend sealants due to their role in primary prevention of cavities on chewing surfaces and secondary prevention by arresting and inhibiting progression of decay. No. What are the indications for dental sealants? Pit and fissure sealants are especially useful for selected patients through the caries active period, which is 6 to 15 years, because permanent molars and premolars erupt during this year of age. Sealants are indicated for teeth with deep pits and fissures, preferably in recently erupted teeth which erupts in less than 4 years. Sealants should be used as part of a prevention program that include the use of fluorides, dietary consideration, plaque control procedures, and regular dental examination. Other indications for the use of sealants are deep retentive patent fissures. If there is no radiographic or clinical evidence of proximal caries, patient with high risk of caries, patient suffering from xerostomia, patient undergoing orthodontic treatment, strained patent fissure with numerous appearance of decalcification. This is classic picture how sealants work. In this picture, you can see permanent first molar is filled with amalgam restoration and second molar has stain on occlusal surface which is filled with pit and fissure sealant. In this picture, you can also see pit and fissure sealants are put into primary first and second molar and permanent molar first molar. Now, what is the technique to apply pit and fissure sealants? First of all, clean and polish the surface on which pit and fissure sealants have to apply. After that, wash the surface and dry with air. Etch the surface with etching solution, which is usually 37% phosphoric acid. Then liquid sealant is applied and cured with the help of LED light cure. Now we will explain the technique for application of sealants. Prior to etching the tooth, isolate the tooth with the help of a rubber dam, cotton roll, or cotton gauze. Etching is done with 35% or 37% phosphoric acid. Etching is delivered to the tooth using the blue tip syringe or using a micro brush. Etch the grooves and cuspal inclines wherever you have to apply sealants. Etch for 15 seconds, wash for 10 seconds, and then evaluate frosted enamel. Apply sealant using the spiral brush tip or using a micro brush. Sealant should flow into grooves and up cuspal inclines and up to cuspal inclines. Cure with the help of LED light cure for 20 seconds. Now, different types of pit and fissure sealants available in dentistry. Resin based sealants. These sealants either cured by chemically or through visible or visible light, which is usually LED light. Most of them are based on viscous resins such as bis gamma and UDMA. TEG-DMA is added to increase the material's flow over the etched enamel surfaces. Some brands contain inorganic fillers like silica to improve the wear resistance property. Some new brands contain fluoride releasing fillers, which fluoride act as a anti-carogenic. Other sealants contain coloring agents to facilitate the controlled application of the material. Glass ionomer based sealants. low consistency glass enamel base sealants has been used for sealing. These materials could withstand for 2 years because these materials have low wear resistance. It is recommended when fissures width is more than 100 micrometer. Composition of glass ionomer based sealants. Fluorosilicate glass powders is combined with a water soluble polymer acid. Example of such glass ionomer based sealant is Kitek cement. Resin modified glass ionomer cements are also available. These cements are glass ionomers with a light polymerized resin component. For example, Witterbond or Wittermer. Glass enamel based sealants chemically bond to enamel. These sealants also release fluoride. There are some new GSE materials like Fuji 7 which have high fluoride release more than 6 times than other restorative glass enamel sealants. New GSE material has good flow properties and flow well into pits and fissures. These GSE material are moisture tolerant. New GSE materials like Fuji 7 has a strong fused layer which is acid resistant and continues to offer protection to occlusal surface even when it appears visually lost due to wear. Restorative glass enamel sealants tend not to be suited as fissure sealants as they are thicker and do not flow well into narrow or deep pits and fissures. Now, what are the advantages of resin modified glass enamels based sealants? These sealants have increased mechanical properties, have physicochemically bond to tooth structure. These sealants are biocompatible and moisture forgiving. These sealants have similar coefficient of thermal expansion as dentine, therefore a good dentine replacement material. These material have iron leachability, which means this material release fluoride which is anti-kerogenic, which has anti-kerogenic action, and these resin modified glass enamel based sealants have minimum polymerization shrinkage. Now, resin-based sealants may or may not contain filler particle or fluoride. The setting reaction can be automatic, which means chemically cured sealants, or light-activated, light-polymerized sealants. These sealants have low viscosity. Resin-based, which means flowable composites, have also been used as fissure sealants. Retention rates are 2% to 80% better than glass enamel based sealants. If there is moderate to high caries risks, we will use resin filled or unfilled sealants. If there is no decay, pit and fissures, then we will just use acid, H, bonding agent, and glass ionomer. And if there is pits and fissure with incipient decay, we will use glass ionomer based sealants. This is the whole lecture on preventive dental materials. Thank you so much.